God wanted to talk about a very important topic, which was extracted from the book of Luke chapter 13, verse 1 to 9. And it's titled Spirit This Year Also. Shall we pray? Gracious and divine Father, we come before your awesome presence this afternoon. Your children are all assembled here, waiting for your word. They are waiting for none other than your word, O Lord. At this point, I pray that, Lord, you hide me beneath the cross. And you, O Lord, speak to your children. Minister unto them to their needs, O Lord. And may they hear your voice. May your Holy Spirit descend and fill this place. And bring every soul and spirit here into total captivity. And may you triumph and your word be heard. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
If we look at the extract that had been read, there are two parts to the extract. Jesus Christ, as he normally does, in his daily routine, has encountered a group of people, a multitude. And during the encounter, there ensued a conversation between Jesus Christ and the multitude.
So that yes,
and the multitude started by telling Jesus Christ an event that had happened in the past. And they went on by narrating the event and saying, "Well, Lord, quite recently there had been a revolt between us and the Roman Empire." And unfortunately, the Roman Emperor, who happened to be the authority was Pontius Pilate, and he was the governor of Judea, so he sent a group of soldiers to come and quell the revolt. In quelling the revolt, they ventured into the precinct of the temple and killed a group of Galilean pilgrims who are in there to offer a sacrifice. So when this story was told to Jesus Christ, you realize that these people were telling this story with a sense of secret satisfaction. And the motive behind it, the story, was what made Jesus Christ respond to the story. The Jews thought they were a much better group of people than the Galileans. And for such a calamity to befall these Galileans, then obviously it means that they might have committed grievous sin again, because that's why God has visited them with such a calamity. They thought they were much better people and they are favored by God. They are not in need of anything. But they are righteous people. But the Galileans are the most grievous people or the most sinful people in the world. Therefore, the punishment that had come their way is fitting and proper. Jesus Christ stopped and said to them,
"The Jesus Christ said, 'Good now, or can say which now?'
In your view, you think you are much better people than the Galileans.
Or say, 'What you say? What make change Galilea for you?'
And you think they are the greatest sinners in the world. That's why this calamity has befallen them.
What is so good there? Or me a man for change or pia into the sa or hurry at all me a man.
But I say unto you, it's no.
Yes, you gotta say empty sa.
But unless you repent from your sins,
and you say, 'What is the sin of your body?'
You shall perish as they. So, at the moment, Jesus Christ is trying to draw the attention of the Jews to the fact that self-righteousness is not the way forward. And self-righteousness is what has made the Jewish nation lost the fact that when Christ was coming, they didn't see him.
Nasa, yet name come yet, you know, and the man a friend you for me. Yes, he's your back, the many kind.
And the Christian at this point in time, but don't we sometimes go that view as well?
It's yes, so for some reason I said, yes, you're the Nisa and you put me now.
Do we sometimes not behave the same way as the Jews secretly were excited about the
problem? Yes, you might need a mono, Yana, your book for mono, chess, you don't deny your person, if you don't say it.
I think the way the calamity has befallen people, we expect the Jews to have shown some sort of sadness and pity towards them.
Mom said, "Okay, the part say if you are sitting here, never sit here, part. Don't you want to be more? I can open the mobile. Not when you are a friend of mine, and somebody comes to school, right?
But instead, they charge the Galilean.
And so said the Italian, the woman who come for say, they beat in a massage.
Instead, they thought they are much better people than the Galileans. Cannot suffer that calamity.
Don't we say, oh, yeah, it's not how we mean to enter.
Do we sometimes judge people and people's character even when we do not have the right to do so?
Yes, I thought that if it's you and people are, oh, surviving one, then you can't help you before. Ah, yes, you can say yes, sir.
And the worst part of it is that it wasn't the multitude who hold this view, but even the disciples also held the same view.
Now, I didn't know what said. Then he could not wash your
but
in Pono, not as young for Canon Pono or more, sir, and JDB.
But they did not turn or did not try to speak at that moment because their master had given them pointed lessons about not judging people.
It's a horrible way, Jimmy, or my man, because now a woman at the actual or crime park is some of us.
They were silent and waited for the master to respond. And the master rebuffed the self-righteousness of the Jews. He said, turn to the multitude, Jesus said, you think these Galileans are sinners above all Galileans? Because they suffered these things?
And now says, sir, we are to Omoti.
I tell you no.
Because
I
said, there be anti, sir.
I said, you repent, you shall likewise perish.
So once it's sir, my brother, also, only check one penny, sir.
There's an object lesson we need to learn.
And the same will happen, I say, if you be in your heart.
These startling calamities were allowed to occur to lead the Jews, first and foremost, and Christendom to humility and repentance of the sin of presumption, self-righteousness and pride.
So how we apply MIA to Shambi who say, see if you say yet to me a Christian for G for the Kenyan, see if you yet now. Saturday is yet to know, and then I'm a swap, and then say, you will see a champion at your call or say.
So as you are seated, I want to do a reflection.
It's a mouth where you are, it will tell you.
I want you to have a deep think about this important point I'm going to relate to you. Think deeply about how badly you have received other people in the past. And also think deeply about how you proudly rated yourself as better than other people. Yes, there are some of us sitting here, if not all of us, we sometimes have this thought that we are better than other people.
Because
some material possession that we possess that other
Because
of an education that you have and other
people do not have the same thing.
Or because of something, a merit that you have that other people do not
have.
So the tendency to underrate them is always there.
And we fall into
that trap day by day.
And
we are always sometimes quick to judge other people. Judge people of their character when we don't even have a right to judge them.
Therefore,
God is telling us today, until we repent, we shall perish as they
do.
So we're going to pray at this moment.
And
ask for God's guidance. Ask for the grace of God, the boundless and
matchless
grace. To attend to us today and help us to be able to submit, to transform us, to humble us, so that we will repent and live a righteous life in the
future.
Shall we all rise up? And as you are standing up,
no, Jamana.
Please close your eyes and pray.
Meditate.
Reflect on ways when you have been so judgmental of other people. And pray for forgiveness.
No, say God.
And ask for the Holy Spirit to humble you. And reflect upon times when you have demonstrated an act of self-righteousness. And ask that the Holy Spirit forgives you. And may the righteousness of Jesus Christ be
imputed to you.
And bring that prayer to a close, shall we ask? One of us to lead us in that
prayer.
He saw how probation will close on humanity. He told a story to forewarn us. And this is how the story goes. The story was a parable. And the parable was riddled with lies, timeless message.
A
certain man had a vineyard. And the vineyard is managed by a gardener or a dresser. And the gardener took all the trouble in the world to manage the vineyard so well. And in three consecutive years, the owner of the vineyard came to the vineyard to look for fruit from the fig tree. He couldn't find any. Therefore, he asked that the tree be cut. But the dresser made a pronounced statement. We'll come back to that later on. And when Jesus made that statement or told that parable,
yes, you can't ask him here, no.
The hearers of the message could not misunderstand the meaning of its application to their lives. Because humanity for whom the Savior came to die is represented in the parable as the fig tree.
If you say,
and the vineyard is the church of God or the world.
Now we will throw no any
for. So you and I seated here are the trees in the vineyard. The master came so many times to look for fruit from the tree.
No, each
time he couldn't find any.
Now baby are in.
And he commanded that those trees be cut and destroyed. The application here is, you and I have been called into the church for a purpose. And God's purpose is for you and I to live a righteous life. To become pointers to other people.
Let me actually have.
But the question is, do our lives reflect that at all?
As if I said, yeah, probably it is time and one.
As I speak, heavens are looking down.
Somebody can say, if you are sure, they could so
air. The multitude of angels are looking down now.
Above me,
and they are reckoning and looking at our lives individually.
Now who care about what it done?
Can they find any fruit in you?
No, but me any
and
the baby one.
And as at that time, the owner could not find any fruit in the vine.
So my
question today is,
to myself, is I say,
if God is looking at you today,
now.
If your life is wrong and accountability is being held about you,
say
what would you say?
Say an omega.
Would you be found wanting?
For
God, according to this parable, there was no fruit found in the
tree. And God has
said in Isaiah 61:3. He said, I've called them into my church, into my fold, that they might be called tree of righteousness. That he, the Lord, might glorify.
So
God wants us to be trees of righteousness. What sort of life do we live in our private life?
In our private
the kind of conversation that we have. And the life that we live day by day. Do this reflect Christ at all? For me, the answer is no. The presumption is it might be the same for you as well. I'm not in past judgment at all. And if you look at the same Isaiah chapter 5, verse 1 to 2, God never just called us here to come and sit down here.
Just
come and sit down here. He called here and
he
fenced us in.
Or so by not yet come
to and he has
come
us land that he has gathered.
Or so our friend is saying, yeah, I'm
just move all the stones and all the thorns away.
Now are you a poor any?
And in the church, he has blessed us with choices.
Now,
God has blessed you and I with the choices that heaven can ever give. He has blessed us, he has given us the strength, he has blessed us with opportunities. But in all these, the question is, what is God getting after lavishing us with the choices from heaven?
I check some point. Oh, even so,
God is not just giving us all these for free.
Onya ni se yepa ni yepi biya keke.
He expects us to do something.
God. I say give him biya efa.
And have we actually sat down to reflect on what God wanted us to do?
The person here, he has just said, "I can do it."
And if you look at Isaiah chapter 5, verse 2.
Isaiah,
he said, and God looked and he should bring forth good grapes, but he brought forth wild grapes. So when God has spent all the time, all the land he can possibly gather to lavish the vineyard, so the vineyard can bear fruit. He came back looking for grapes. And all he found is wild grapes. Implying that God's people today make greater show of piety. As the Israelites did.
Said
the Israelites, yet we are destitute of the sweet grace of the Spirit of God.
Then so Unyakopon after watching the
we are living life devoid of the Spirit of God. The very thing that we do, our pronouncement, our actions, within the church and out of the church, demonstrate that. And the precious fruit of character that made the life of Joseph so fragrant and beautiful were not manifested in us.
Emma Joseph, Ababa, Namaya, Kamano, Jane,
and God and His Son is seeking fruit and found nothing.
Abu Ahri, and now the Banasun,
God is looking into the church today, seeking to find anybody who will stand tall and great and manifesting the fruit of the Spirit and cannot find any.
Abu Ahri, himself, open up your free moon,
and all we are doing is that we have come back. Ground. And we have come
on
the ground and taken the opportunity that people who really mean business should be having.
It's your friend, you're not going to be any of your jack intention.
And God is calling us to order today.
Uncle Paul, F.A.D.H.N.E.N.E.
Brothers and sisters,
and you know,
soon and very soon, probation will close. We have lived our life
like
the Laodicean church did live their life. If you read from Revelation chapter 3, verse 14 to 18,
it says
the one who is faithful says, I know thy works. I know thy way, your ways. You are neither cold nor you are lukewarm. And because you are lukewarm, I will spew you out of my mouth. And you say to yourself,
okay,
I'm rich.
May only four.
I need nothing.
Me yummy.
Children of God.
Everyone.
That is a very difficult and very dangerous state to be in. He who knows not.
The only one know.
And knows not that he knows not.
Now only is the only one know.
Is in a very difficult situation.
Oh baby, take me more.
You don't know it.
Call your own way.
Yet you don't know, you don't know.
There's no one who wants to be.
Then how can you go and get salvation?
We are destitute
of the Spirit of God.
We are living
life full of futility. And when God has looked into us, he cannot find the fruit that he must find. And we say to ourselves that we are the righteous.
There's a catch here, I will say, yeah, it's
ready. Yet we say to ourselves that we are rich.
And we
do not need anything. We are just like Laodicean church. And God is warning us that if we don't change our habit today, there will come a time
that
he's going to spew us out of his mouth. And he's calling us out to come and buy from him.
And your friend said,
pure gold.
Sika.
Representing the righteousness of Jesus Christ. Oh, you, I say, whoa, there is come a day of wrath of God. And soon and very soon, provision is going to close. There is no more time to waste or sit on the fringes of life.
I say, and maybe anyone said, open to me, ask us to say, oh, I can't.
Honestly speaking, I just want to remain in the church of God and return our tithe, return our offering, do all that we have to do. Then was a small thought for God.
Save it, man. Ask for and you do a bang. Yeah, yes, yeah, 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 yeah. And then he said, it's me, Gina.
Oh, we'll be better off going out there and spending our time doing all that the world gives.
And yes, I mean, it could be a safe credit as a food in
the day. You are denying yourself of all the faint pleasures of the world, yet.
If you say, oh, yeah, and I said, change in our house, we are destitute
of the Spirit of God in here.
And
if we carry on with this life, we might lose eternity.
And this
is a warning from God to all of us, not
for
me.
Well,
the Lord of mercy is for warning of the calamity that lies ahead of the unrepentant soul. Are you of careless heart, a fruitless tree in the Lord's vineyard?
Now,
fruitless tree in the Lord's church? How long have you received the divine gift from God and his message of repentance and forgiveness?
If I was saying that, I'm not going to say
we have taken the name of God and outwardly a member of the church, which is the body of Christ. Yet are conscious of no living connection with the Savior. So if you are seated here, you know you have no living connection with the Savior, you know it yourself. Because you know the life you live in secrecy. And I know the life I live in secrecy. And if I have connection with the Savior, I know.
And you cannot know what can be a belief.
So if you are conscious of the fact that you don't have that set, that connection with the Savior and still see that you can continue with that life, then that is a precarious situation to be in.
And he said, sir, who is on that you can't be a non-individual?
God will save us.
How will save us?
He's looking into the vineyard now.
Oh, shame will be true.
Your life is under the spotlight of God. God is scrutinizing every moment, every motive, every action you go through day by day. Can he find any fruit in you? I urge you to consider your lives. I urge all of us to consider our ways. What the Savior wants to save us. I'm pretty sure we do realize how we have misrepresented God in the past. We call ourselves Adventists, but we don't live by the precept and the tenets of God. We call ourselves the remnant church, But actually, the message that the remnant church should go to the world with, we're not living by those words.
Yeah, first say, So
our life is a misrepresentation of God. We are misrepresenting God to the whole world.
It's your God saying, "You see, you need the whole action of your ministers, your human."
And how long have you
been doing it? The very thing I'm trying to say, yeah.
And when the owner of the vineyard told the dresser, "Cut it off." The dresser or the gardener said something.
He
said, "Master,
so Obra,
can you spare one more year?
Wait me, I should have three back open.
Master, one more year, I beg you.
See, I feel back open, Mr.
And give me an opportunity this time to lavish it more.
Now we're fruitful from transactional, now we're transuming a man.
And to pour and till the soil and actually give it everything that it will need.
Not the only idea, when from my own, the more it is.
And if after 1 year it does not bear any fruit,
see, I feel trembling, that's the one swap by the hour.
Well, then you can cut it off.
And it will make happen.
Guys, we are at that period of time.
Yes, amen.
When God, creator of everything, has had enough of this world.
And then now,
I want to destroy this world.
Oh, pastor, I'm saying.
His son Jesus Christ, who is the dresser.
Yes, you are. Oh, you're here.
He's saying, one more time.
Father,
I died on the cross of Calvary because of them. Father, give them one more opportunity. Let me send all the divine messages unto them as I'm sending today. The Lord, you can cut him off.
Yeah, you make your company.
Pregnant soon and very soon.
If you have an angel,
I can be called any moment.
With my friend, baby.
You can be called any moment.
With my friend, baby.
Probation can be closed on any of us.
With me, I can bear to my cat, baby.
Probation closed on you today.
Say, a cat is a bear.
Will God find any fruit in you? I'm
going to be a cat.
Or you will cut it down.
I know, with your company.
My prayer to all of you, may the good Lord bless all of you. May the good Lord endow you in the Holy Spirit. May the good Lord revive you in the Holy Spirit. May His way of blessing come to you day by day. May the word quicken your soul and spirit. So that we shall be transformed. So that we shall be changed. So the righteousness of Christ shall be imputed upon us. So when provision closes on us, we shall be found as people who have bear forth fruit.
And
we shall enjoy eternity. God bless you.
Yeah.